How are you this morning? I pray that you're doing well. I pray that you find yourself in good health and in good spirits. Friends, our Lord calls us to walk in love, to do everything in love. What greater love is than what he has done? He went to the cross and shed his blood so that we can live. There's no greater demonstration of love than what our Lord Jesus Christ has done for us. So you can know that you are loved. You are a loved person and you're loved by God. And now we can freely walk in that love that he has poured upon us. You are the light of the world. You are the salt of the earth. God has made you the salt so that you could go and season everywhere that you go. Everywhere that you go, let your light shine. Let your light shine. You are allowing him to be seen through you. You are filled with the Holy Spirit. You are a carrier of his glory. So every time that you shine, you are allowing him to be seen. You are allowing him to shine through you. You are the salt of the earth. And if the salt loses its flavor, then what will we use to season the earth? That's how important you are. You are the salt of the earth. So everywhere that you go, everywhere that you go, you shine for the Lord. You shine for him. Everywhere that you go, you season every place that you go. So know that you are his light. You are his salt, and he is the one utilizing you for his glory. He reveals himself to you. He reveals himself to you when you seek him in prayer. So seek him in prayer. Spend time with him in prayer, because he wants to reveal himself. He wants for you to awaken. Awaken. Now is the time to awaken. Awaken from your sleep. He wants to reveal himself to you. He wants to reveal things to you that are in the scriptures. He wants to reveal his word to you, and know that he is a faithful God. He's faithful and true, and he remains faithful to his word. So you can trust in him. You can trust in the faithfulness of our Lord Jesus Christ. He wants to reveal himself to you. He wants to fill you. And that's what we are encouraged to pray without ceasing. Because when we pray, we are filled. He wants to fill you. When you surrender yourself to him, when you surrender your all, then he can give you of himself to you. And he wants to give all himself to you, not just in certain areas of your life, but in every area of your life. And that's what we are encouraged to give him our all, so that we can receive his all, so that he can fill you with all of him. He wants to fill you. You are a river of living water. He wants to fill you so that you can continue to flow, so that water continues to flow through you. You are that oil that continues to flow, and he wants to fill you completely. He wants to continue to fill you, can continue to fill you so that you can continue to give. Every time we are refreshed by his spirit. We can go out and be a refreshment to others. You can go and refresh others with words of encouragement. You are that salt that he utilizes for you to go and season every place that you go. A city on a hill cannot be hidden. So abide in his presence, remain in the presence of our Lord, and know that he is the one reviving your spirit. He is the one that's bringing this revival into you so that you can go and be a refreshment to others. He's the one utilizing you so that you can go in his name, so that you can go as he guides you and go to the places that he leads you. He is the one that is leading you through the Holy Spirit, and he is the one making revival take place. There's a lot of revival that's happening right now throughout the world. Right now we are in a miracle season. There are miracles that are taking place, and just as he promised, signs and wonders will follow you. So right now there's miracles that are happening, and there's revival that's happening in other parts of the world. So know that he is utilizing you as well. So Awaken, he says, awaken. Now is the time to awaken. Now is the time for you to seek him, because he wants to reveal of himself to you. He wants for you to know more of who he is. So trust in him and trust in how he guides you and how he leads you. You can walk with him in faith and know that he is a faithful God who remains faithful to his word. His word never changes, and he remains faithful to it. And you are encouraged to meditate on his word day and night and do according to it. And you will see how he makes your way prosperous so that you can have good success. And just like he told Joshua to be strong and courageous, he tells you to be strong. So you remain in his strength. Remain strong and courageous, because the Lord your God is with you. So don't dismay. Do not be afraid. He is with you everywhere that you go. So everywhere that he sends you, everywhere that he tells you to go and go season, every place that he tells you to go, know that he is right there with you through the Holy Spirit. You can trust in him. He remains faithful to his word, so you can stand firm in his promises. And you can gain the strength that you need through the Spirit. He is giving you that strength that you need, and you can know and trust that he is with you. So you have nothing to be afraid of. You have nothing to fear, because he is with you. And just as he promised, he will be with you. And you can freely walk in that love that the Lord has showed you. You can freely walk in the love and go share that love that he has poured into you. So know that he reveals himself, just like he revealed himself to Mary Magdalene. In the same way, he reveals himself, and he wants to reveal things that are hidden things. He wants to bring them to the light so that you can know more of who he is. He is the spirit of prophecy, the star of the morning, the spirit of prophecy. And he's the one who reveals himself. And know that he is doing all these things. He says those that are thirsty, he fulfills their thirst. He fulfills them with his spirit. And that's what he is doing. He is fulfilling us with his spirit. Every time we seek him in prayer, he's fulfilling us through the Spirit. And that's why we are encouraged to give him our all, so that we can receive more of him. Because he doesn't just want to fulfill just certain areas of our body or certain areas of our life. He wants to fulfill everything in your life, so that you can go and be a refreshment to others, so that you can go and season, be that salt of the earth, who he has called you to be, the light of the world, for you to go and shine your light to every place that he sends you. So friends, know that you have a faithful God, a God who is faithful and true, and you can trust in him, trust in how he leads you. So let's pray for those who are sick. If you're feeling pain or discomfort in any area of your body, I encourage for you to place your hand, and we're gonna declare healing in the name of Jesus. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, here I come before your presence, declaring healing. All of those that are suffering with cancer, I declare all cancer to be healed in Jesus' mighty name. I declare healing of all of those that are suffering with stomach issues. Ligaments are being healed in Jesus' mighty name. The Lord is real. He is aligning things, putting things back together. And we're in a miracle season, so there's supernatural things that are taking place in the Spirit. So he is doing miraculous things. Miracles are coming to pass. Now is the time. He is doing miracles, friends. So seek him, seek him. Now is the time to seek him. I want to declare healing from the crown of your head all the way down to the soles of your feet. For respiratory problems, those that are having issues breathing, I declare you healed in Jesus' mighty name. Coronavirus, I declare it healed in Jesus' mighty name. I declare healing from the crown of your head all the way down to the soles of your feet. I declare you to be healed in Jesus' mighty name. I pray, amen and amen. Friends, thank you for joining me in the prayer of healing. I also would like to say the declaration of faith. You know, the Lord has many gifts ready to gift us, but the greatest miracle that we can receive is salvation. If you please say this declaration of faith with me. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, here I come before your presence. I ask you, Lord Jesus, to come into my heart. I declare at this moment that you are my Lord and you are my Savior. Amen, amen. Friends, for those who made the declaration of faith, congratulations to you. Please know that the angels in heaven rejoice every single time someone makes the declaration of faith. I rejoice with you. I congratulate and encourage for you to remain connected with the Lord through prayer and his word. And the scripture tells us that those who seek him will seek great and mighty things. It's not about religion, but it is about having a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. Friends, I hear multiplication in my spirit. Multiplication. God is multiplying. He is doing miracles, supernatural things. So he is multiplying. So seek him now because he is multiplying. Whatever it is that you have in your hand, know that he is multiplying it. He is bringing increase. So trust in him. He is faithful. Friends, he is faithful. He is a faithful God. So know that he remains true to his word. There's never a moment that he moves away from his word, so you can trust in him. And he is revealing himself. He is bringing revelation to you. So trust in him and how he leads you. Walk in love, remain in faith, and know that he gives you the strength that you need. So be strong and courageous because he is with you. He's with you everywhere that you go, everywhere he sends you, everywhere he reveals these supernatural things that are happening, blessings that are taking place, miracles that are happening. Know that it is him sending you, and you are the salt of the earth, and everywhere that he sends you, you are bringing flavor into it. You are letting your light shine. You are letting your light shine. And every time you let your light shine, you are exposing who he is through you. He wants to be seen through you. You are a carrier of his glory. You are a carrier of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit abides in you. So his whole being is in you. And he wants to shine right through you. He wants to shine through you. So let your light shine so that others can see the Lord Jesus Christ through you, friends. Have a beautiful day. God bless you. Bye.